and obey Allah and his messenger. It's specifically saying obey Allah and his messenger. Who was his messenger? Rasulullah. Muhammad. He wasn't talking about Jesus, and he wasn't talking about Moses. He said messenger. And not a plural, singular. And that was in his present time while he was receiving the Quran. So, we have to obey the Quran. And it's not what Josh say, the Bible. Now, I don't know how he figured this whole thing out and how he got this scheme going, but I just showed you and laid out everything from the Arabic and went outside the book and came back and shown you Muslims supposed to follow, read, and obey and study the Quran. It doesn't even make logical sense. Why would Allah give the Quran if we were supposed to believe in the Bible and the Bible was perfect? And I'm going to get into that later on. If it was perfect, there's no need for a Quran. It makes absolutely no sense if we're not supposed to believe in Quran or study it and just do study the Bible. It makes absolutely no sense, people. So I will end there, and we can hear Brother Josh's story and what he got to say.
All right, once again, you're tuned in to the Bay Talk for You, Season 2. My special guest is Brother Josh from Absolute Bible Truth, and Raheem Ali represent Islam. The number is 877-280-9681. Once again, the number is 877-280-9681. The title of this debate is, Does the Quran Demand Muslims to Obey the Bible? For those who just tuned in, welcome to the show, especially the first-time listeners out there. Switchboards is almost filled up, actually. And I appreciate everybody that's calling in right now via your phone, tuned into the Bay Talk for You in this particular debate. Okay, so now we're going to go to Brother Josh right now for his opening statement, which will be 15 minutes as well. Let me check this out. Brother Josh, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, you can go ahead.
Okay, I'm just very shocked at several things that the brother said. Number one, that he barely used, if I'm not correct, even 10 minutes of his time. And I would advise him to utilize every minute that he has, because he's going to definitely need them. I'm letting y'all see right here that the brother made several mistakes already off the bat about what I said and what I believe. First of all, any Muslim can go into the Quran and show you verses talking about believing and reading the Quran. Anybody can do that. But what happens when you go into verses talking about the book that came before the Quran? I noticed that Raheem conveniently did not do that. And when he addressed my YouTube video, I have a YouTube video on this, he didn't even address any other verses I went to in the Quran showing what it says about the Bible. He just proceeded to attack the Bible itself, and as I suspected, he's doing the same thing now. First of all, people, in jail, as he talked about, that is the Arabic word for gospel, and it refers to the gospel in the Bible, the four gospels. How do I know this? Because if you ask any Muslim, is Muhammad mentioned in the Bible, they would say yes. If you ask them where, they would say in the Torah or the Torah and the Injil or the gospel. And then if you ask them to show you that, they don't say, well, that Bible or that book no longer exists. They go right to your Bible. But yet, when they want to belittle the Bible, they'll say things like, that's not the same gospel during that time. Well, how come it's the same gospel when you want to go in your Quran, and the Quran says that Muhammad is mentioned or prophesied in the gospel, then you go to the Bible then. But when somebody says, well, you know, the gospel says you're supposed to do this, the Quran says this good about the gospel, they say, well, that's not the same gospel. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to actually go to Quranic verses and show you what the Quran says on this. First of all, let me show you that Muhammad did not believe that the Torah or the Injil or the Bible was corrupt. That's nowhere found in the Quran. We're going to go to Surah 19 and 12 first. This is about John the Baptist. Look what it says he is going to do. And by the way, for everybody, I am reading the M.A.S. Abdel Halim translation of the Bible. I have the Abdul Yusuf Ali version too, but I like this one better, right? Check this out. This is Surah 19 and 12. Notice I'm giving you Quranic verses dealing with what I'm talking about. Look what it says right here. We said, John, come out, John the Baptist, hold on to the scripture firmly while he was still a boy. We granted him wisdom. So he told him to hold on to the scriptures. We know this is not talking about the Quran, because the Quran was not even written yet. Muhammad wasn't even born yet. He was born 500 years after this, right? Then this lets you know something else, that Muhammad is recording that John the Baptist was told to obey the scriptures. It said the scriptures. This is what we know today as the Bible. You're not going to find the word Bible in the Quran, sisters and brothers, so don't bother looking. Why? Because the word Bible is a Latin word, and it just means books. That's all it means. So you're not going to find the word Bible. So don't let a Muslim try to deceive you. I don't see anything about any Bible, but the word Bible means books. But you will find the word book referring to the words and the book in the Bible several times in the Quran. But right now we're seeing that God told John the Baptist to teach the scripture, which means that Muhammad did not believe that the scriptures were corrupted in John the Baptist's time. Right? But let's move on. We're going to go to Surah 3 and 47. See, Raheem is not going to be able to explain these. He's just going to read around them, or he's going to just try to attack the validity of the Bible itself. He's not going to say anything about what this says. And the funny thing is, they have the Dead Sea Scrolls, which was discovered in 1947. They have copies of it enough to form almost another Bible. Said the exact same thing that our Bible says today. So if the Bible was corrupt, how did it say the same thing that it says today before Muhammad came on the scene? You also have the Septuagint says the same thing, and the differences are minimal. Nothing that affects doctrine or understanding, the differences are minimal. So the same Bible that we have today that we're reading out of said the same thing during Muhammad's time, and he told people to read it. So if the Bible was corrupt and Muhammad knew it, why would he tell people to read it? And I'm going to show you that, but first we're going to Surah 3 and 47. Because his brother, he's not going to address any of this. This Surah 3 and 47, look what it says, right? This is Mary talking about the virgin birth. She said, "My Lord, how can I have a son when no man has touched me?" This sounds very familiar. Doesn't it sound like what you read in Luke in the New Testament? Saying the same thing. We'll let you know that the Bible says the same thing. Look what it says. The angel, Tamal Gabriel, said, "This is how God creates what he will. When he has ordained something, he only says, be. And it is." Now he's telling you what Jesus is going to do. He will teach him the scripture and wisdom, the Torah and the gospel. According to Muhammad, the angel Gabriel told the Virgin Mary that Jesus would teach Torah and gospel. And like I said, the Old Testament, as we have it right now, has been in existence since 200 B.C. It says the same thing. You don't have to do nothing to get online and look up the Dead Sea Scrolls, and you'll see that I'm telling the truth. And it says the same thing now. Meaning, if it said the same thing before Muhammad, and it said the same thing after Muhammad, and Muhammad never said it was corrupted, where is Raheem and these other diehard Muslims getting their doctrine from that the Bible corrupted? Because it doesn't say it anywhere in the Quran. On the contrary, the Quran speaks highly of the Bible. Well, let me show you something else. We're going to read, let's see where I stopped at. Okay, let's go to Surah 4 and verse 136. This is the Quran. I'm not going to read a single Bible verse tonight unless Raheem asked me to do something or ask me something about the Bible. This is all Quran I'm giving y'all tonight. I got several passages. Several. Not one or two. Several. This is Surah 4 and 136. Look what it says right here. It says, let me check I got my right spot. It says, the reward for such people is forgiveness from the Lord and the garden's grace. I'm going to not be reading the right thing. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm in 3. I'm sorry. 4 and 136. 4. I'm sorry. Here we go. Right here. Surah 4 and 136. Look what it says. You who believe. This is talking about Raheem, Muslim. Look what it says. You who believe. Believe in God, Allah, and his messenger, Muhammad. And in the scripture, he sent down to his messenger, the Quran, as well as what he sent down before. This is clear, ladies and gentlemen. If the Quran told you to believe in Muhammad and the Quran, and that means to follow what the Quran says, then why is it when it says believe in what was sent down before that, that don't mean follow the Bible? I'm confused. It said, let me read it again. You will believe, Raheem and other Muslims, believe in God and His messenger, that means follow Allah and Muhammad, right? And in the scripture, He sent down to His messenger, talking about the Quran, as well, that means in addition to the Quran, as well as what He sent down before, talking about before the Quran. That's the Torah and the Injil, something, brother. That's what that is. And as I said, and it can be easily proven, the Torah and the Gospels, they got thousands of copies of manuscripts, say the same thing now that it said in Muhammad's time and earlier. So it was not corrupted. Why would Muhammad have Allah tell him to say this, or why would Allah say this to him if Allah knew full well that by the time Muhammad came on the scene, the Bible was corrupt, or the books that make up the Bible was corrupt? Raheem can't answer these questions without speculation or personal opinion. He can't give you any facts. He's going to tell you what he thinks, he's going to give you a little song and dance, and then he's going to try to give you a smoke screen. That's what he's going to do, because that's what he's always been doing. But this is clear. This is from the Quran, not the Bible. This is straight up Quran. And you can read it in Arabic, Turkish, whatever language, it says the same thing. But let's move on. We're still in the Quran. We're going to go to Surah 6. This is clear to me. I don't need anybody to debate this. It's not even a debate what the Quran says about the Bible or what the Quran says about the book that we call the Bible today. Because that's what it is. No, you're not going to find the word Bible in the Quran. Don't even bother looking for it. But you will find reference to the books that made up the Bible. So don't let them try to say that's a magic. They don't say Bible. Of course they don't say Bible. It wasn't called the Bible back then. So why would they have the word Bible in the Quran? That's common sense. This is 6 and 115. Surah 6 and 115. Listen to this. Now, if you ask any Muslim, is the Bible the word of Allah? They'll say some of it. But what happened to the rest of it? Oh, it was altered. It was changed. Look what Muhammad says right here. The word of your Lord is complete in its truth and justice. No one can change his words. He is the all-hearing and all-knowing. If you ask any Muslim, they'll say, well, it's talking about the Quran. But you're contradicting yourself because you're saying that some of the Bible is the word of Allah. Any Muslim will tell you that, well, some of it's good. But if you're telling me the rest of it is not good, then you are telling me that somebody indeed did change his word. That's not what the Quran says. The Quran doesn't teach that anybody changed Allah's word or they've been careful with it. It says people lie with their lips about it. They lie with their lips. They don't actually change the written word. So don't try to say, well, this is talking about the Quran. No, it says nobody can change his word. The Bible or original books before the Quran was the word of Allah, and somebody changed it, then that makes this verse a lie. Because somebody changed it. Or do you try? Or they try to say, well, that meant once the Quran came, nobody could change it after that. Somebody show me that in the Quran. It doesn't say that in the Quran. So don't try to put your own little spin and interpretation on it either. Just like I'm absolute Bible truth, when it comes to the Quran, I'm also absolute Quran truth. If it's not in the Quran and you're a Muslim and you're trying to make me believe it, I don't want to hear it. If it doesn't say it in the Quran, I don't want to hear it. And I'm not even a Muslim, but I respect the Muslim faith enough that if a Muslim steps to me and tells me this is what Allah said, it better be in that Quran or I don't want to hear it. Right? But let's keep it moving. We're going to go back to Surah 4 and 46. And notice I'm reading straight out the Quran. I'm not twisting anything. These are plain, clear, concise verses and surahs. They're plain. But Raheem don't want to believe it because he wants people to think that the Bible's corrupt and it contains fairy tales. So there's no way Muhammad would tell anybody to read it. It's tampered with. But when they want to get that comforter, when they want to get that prophet mentioned in Deuteronomy 18, they go straight to your Bible then, don't they? They don't have a problem with the Bible when it comes to pulling Muhammad out of it, but when you read other stuff that the Quran says about the Bible, all of a sudden, well, you can't trust it. Then how did I know that Deuteronomy 18 wasn't careful with, or John 14? This is the hypocrisy of the Muslim, not Josh, not the Christian, not the Hebrew Israelite. This is the hypocrisy of the Muslim. Either stay away from the Bible because it's corrupt, or believe everything it says. But let me show you something else. This is Surah 4 and 46. Surah 4 and 46. It's a very small book I'm reading out of, so you know you got to be careful how many pages you turn. 4 and 46. Listen to this. Some Jews distort the meaning of revealed words. They say, we hear and disobey. And listen, adding the insult. May you not hear and reina. Look at you, twisting it abusively with their tongues so as to disparage religion. It says they twist it with their tongues, sisters and brothers. It didn't say they rewrote anything. It didn't say they twisted with their tongues. Why am I taking you out here? Because you have Muslims that say, they see, they twisted. No, it said with their tongues. Just like I can be reading the Bible or Quran, and I don't change a single thing in it, but I verbalize something different from what's actually written in those books. But we're going to go to Surah 6 and 115. And then I end my turn. This is Surah 6 and 115. Surah 6 and 115. I've just been given a two-minute warning, too, so this is perfect. Oh, okay. I already read it. Well, I'll read Surah 3 and 2 through 4 then. I wrote the same thing twice. Surah 3 and 2 through 4. Look what this says right here. Pay close attention to what this says. Surah 3, verses 2 through 4. And here we go right here. Look what it says. It says, God, there is no God but Him, the ever-living, the ever-watchful. Step by step, He has sent the scripture down to you, prophet, with the truth, confirming what went before. So Muhammad came to confirm what went before him. That means he came to strengthen or elaborate on the Bible. Not say it was tabooed, not say it was altered. Thank you for your time.
All right, once again, you're now locked in to Debate Talk for You. My special guest is Raheem Ali, representing Islam, and Brother Josh, representing Absolute Bible Truth.